We have a winner, education in North Carolina. We have winners every time lottery funds are used to help build a new school or make necessary renovations. When an at-risk child gets life experience through More at Four, class sizes are reduced, and when thousands of students across the state get help going to college. The governor and the legislature have made education a high priority because today's students are tomorrow's leaders. On August 31, 2005, then-Governor Michael F. Easley signed the North Carolina State Lottery Act into law. The governor, Speaker of the House, and President Pro Tem of the Senate appointed a lottery commission. The commission then named an executive director, Tom Shaheen, who hit the ground running in December 2005. In record pace, just 3 months and 25 days, the North Carolina Education Lottery launched and sold its first tickets March 30, 2006. Since then, the North Carolina Education Lottery has made a big impact on education, raising more than $900 million for education in the first 2.5 years. That amount continues to grow daily. In a December 2008 Greensboro News and Record interview, Governor Easley reflected back on his 8 years in office. He was asked if he was satisfied with the lottery. He was quoted, "We've got $1 million a day going into the school system, and that pays for the most regressive segment of our education system, which is the pre-K, class size, eliminating the achievement gap." To be specific, the Lottery Act designates 4 beneficiary programs. It states that the commission shall distribute the net revenue of the Education Lottery Fund with 50% for reduction of class size in early grades, to not exceed an average of 18 students for every teacher, and for academic pre-kindergarten programs for at-risk four-year-olds, 40% to school construction and renovations, and 10% to fund need-based college and university scholarships. Already, all across the state, there are new schools constructed and existing schools renovated with the help of lottery funds. Thousands of pre-kindergartners getting their first classroom experiences in More at Four, and tens of thousands of college students who have received need-based college scholarships from the lottery. So how does the lottery operate, and how do the funds raised by the lottery get to each county? The lottery is an independent state agency governed by a commission and headed by an executive director. Tom Shaheen, the lottery executive director and first employee, has more than 21 years of experience in the lottery industry. The goal for Shaheen and all the lottery employees is to maximize lottery sales to raise as much money as possible for education. The lottery's role stops there. Other state agencies are responsible for disbursing the funds. After each fiscal quarter, the lottery transfers its net proceeds to the North Carolina Education Lottery Fund at the Office of State Budget and Management. From there, State Budget and Management disperses the funds to the Department of Public Instruction for all the beneficiary programs except college scholarships, which is handled by the North Carolina State Education Assistance Authority.
The lottery funds are received and divided between reducing class size and supporting construction projects. The class size funds are put in place at the beginning of the school year, so schools know exactly what amount of money they can expect. But the construction funds are allocated and do flow throughout the year based on the allocation and based on the needs of the system and based on the applications that are set forth by the school system.
The More at Four program and class size reduction share the largest piece of the pie at 50%. More at Four is a program to help at-risk four-year-olds develop essential learning skills. Since the program has started receiving the lottery funds, it has experienced various changes.
Well, I think the program's changed in a couple of different ways. It's grown tremendously. We have moved from a program year in 2001-2002 serving about 1,200 students to serving over 32,000 students, and the lottery has been a big part of that.
Pruitt added that the program also has grown in per-child funding from $3,200 to an average of $5,000 per child statewide. He said that North Carolina's high standards for the More at Four program have led to recognition from the National Institute for Early Education Research. According to Pruitt, research has shown that children can vary greatly in social skill levels when it is time to begin school. With the More at Four program, students are assisted with classroom skills and develop strong learning habits in order to improve their opportunities for success in public school, and hopefully putting them on a path to attend and finish high school and go to college. All counties in North Carolina benefit from lottery dollars for class size reduction in grades K through 3. This initiative funds teaching positions and assists in bringing the average student-teacher ratio to one teacher for every 18 students.
It is important because it allows teachers to have more time to focus on their students as individuals. Many of our students need a great deal more nurturing than some others. And so teachers can then not only structure instructional programs to meet the student's needs, but they can also interact with the student in a way to find the weaknesses and then be able to respond to strengthening the students where they most need it.
The second highest percentage of net proceeds from the education lottery is for school construction and renovations. This could be anything from repairing a leaking roof to building a new school from the ground up, or like the Alamance Burlington school system, adding on classrooms where most needed to an existing structure.
B. Everett Jordan Elementary School is one of our elementary schools that's in a high growth area. And we had, I think, 7 mobile units on site. So we're able to use the first construction portion of the lottery proceeds to build 6 additional classrooms. If the lottery funds aren't there, we're not able to do that. So we're able to get all of our kids under one roof and get them out of those mobile units.
Burke County School Superintendent David Burleson also worked with his county commissioners to utilize lottery money for construction and capital improvements.
We've also had the opportunity to construct 2 brand new high schools, plus a 5th middle school, and that middle school was paid for totally when we moved in. And the lottery did help us with that. The lottery has helped us build the 2 new high schools and to pay what I would say the house payment on those buildings.
The money is allocated to counties based on student population and county property tax rate. Individual counties make the decision of how to use the money once it is allocated. Beyond new school construction, counties have several additional options, which include banking the money for future use, using the money to repay school bonds, using the money for smaller capital projects such as new roofs, new HVAC systems, new security systems, land purchases, school renovations, and school additions.
It has allowed us to take care of a lot of small and large projects. The most that happened in 2007 was roof replacements and waterproofing, and then of course security equipment, carpeting, floor tile replacements, also upgrades in our cafeteria facilities.
The Lottery Act designates 10% of lottery proceeds for need-based college scholarships. In the 2007-2008 school year, approximately 30,000 students received a lottery scholarship. The College Foundation of North Carolina expects that number to be the average or higher in the coming years.
The Education Lottery Scholarship ranges in amount from $100 to $2,500. Those funds are typically applied first to the student's tuition and fees, but if their scholarship exceeds those tuition and fees, they may be applied to college room and board if they're living on campus. It may go to assisting the student in purchasing books and supplies for classes.
Students interested in receiving a lottery scholarship need only to send to the College Foundation the Free Application for Federal Student Aid, also known as FAFSA. For some students, the scholarship allows them to focus solely on their studies and not have to split their time with a job.
It was pretty exciting. I hadn't received any scholarship my first 2 years, being a junior. Trying to scramble and coming up with money and pay for school was pretty hard. And then to open up my financial aid package and see that I had received money made life seem a little bit more easier.
Students attending state universities, community colleges, or one of the North Carolina independent colleges and universities are eligible for lottery scholarships. The North Carolina Education Lottery has provided an influx of new dollars to education, but the buck doesn't stop there. Over 95 cents of every dollar of lottery sales is returned to the state in some form, to education, to players, and to retailers.
It makes me proud first and foremost to know that education is a winner. It's also fun to see lucky players who do win some money and have fun playing. Many of those players take their winnings and buy a car, a house, furniture, and that helps make the economy a winner. And finally, there are thousands of retailers statewide who, through teaming up with the lottery, grow their business.
So the next time you play the North Carolina Education Lottery, remember, you are scratching off today for tomorrow's success.